Hello everyone, welcome back to Creation DUI. In today's video, we're going to try something unique. What happens when cement is mixed with gasoline? At first, it might sound impossible, but this mixture can actually be very useful for daily needs. Stay tuned, because I'll show you step by step how to make it. Prepare a container. You can use an old jar or any other container you have. Next, fill the container with gasoline. Then, add the cement you've prepared into the container with gasoline. Pour it in gradually, spoon by spoon, so the mixture blends together properly. Normally, you might see cement being mixed with water, but this time it's different. I'm showing you how cement can actually dissolve in gasoline. Which country are you watching this video from? Write it in the comments to let me know. I'm really happy that we can connect with each other from all around the world. The mixture of gasoline and cement produces something very different from the usual cement and water mix, which normally hardens into a solid. When mixed with gasoline, the texture becomes more liquid, sticky, and it cannot harden like regular cement. This mixture looks unique because gasoline acts as a solvent, preventing the cement from forming strong bonds like it does with water. This is what makes the gasoline and cement mixture so different, giving it unusual properties compared to regular cement mixtures. Once the cement and gasoline are thoroughly mixed, prepare a container with a lid. Make sure the mixture is fully blended for the best results. Spoon some of the mixture into the prepared container. Then close it tightly. Next, add gasoline to the remaining cement mixture. Then, prepare a material that's easy to find around the house, styrofoam. Slowly add the styrofoam into the gasoline and cement mixture, making sure everything mixes together properly. It's important to know that styrofoam will dissolve when mixed with gasoline. This happens because gasoline acts as a strong chemical solvent, breaking down the light and porous structure of styrofoam. As the styrofoam dissolves, it turns into a sticky, thick material that can blend seamlessly with the cement mixture. This process gives the mixture a unique texture, not only denser, but also more flexible and easier to shape compared to regular cement. Moreover, the reaction between gasoline, cement, and styrofoam creates properties that are very unusual, completely different from conventional cement mixtures. That's why this combination is so fascinating to observe and produces results that are truly unique in various experiments or creative projects. As an example, this mixture can be used to repair a broken bucket. I have a broken bucket, and now I'll show you how to fix it using this mixture. The first step is to sand the area of the bucket that needs repair. Sanding helps the mixture adhere perfectly to the bucket surface. After sanding the damaged area of the bucket, the next step is to apply tape to the inside of the broken section. The tape acts as a barrier, preventing the sticky mixture from flowing inside the bucket and ensuring it stays exactly where it is needed. Once the tape is in place, carefully pour the gasoline cement styrofoam mixture onto the broken area. Use a spatula or your hands to spread it evenly, making sure all gaps and cracks are fully covered. Because of its sticky and slightly flexible texture, the mixture adheres well to the bucket surface and can effectively fill irregular shapes. This process ensures a strong and stable patch while creating a smooth and even surface, making the repair both functional and visually neat. After the mixture has been applied and smoothed out, leave the repaired area to set for 24 hours. This allows the mixture to harden completely and adhere firmly to the bucket, ensuring a durable and long-lasting repair. After 24 hours, remove the tape from the inside of the bucket. Now you can see the results of the repair. The outcome is truly impressive. The mixture has hardened perfectly and adheres firmly to the bucket surface. If desired, you can sand the outer area of the patch to make it smoother and more even. Keep in mind, the appearance of the patch is not the main focus. The primary purpose is functionality. This mixture is designed to repair and hold water, not to provide a perfect visual finish. Next, I will test the repaired bucket to see how well the patch holds. The goal is to ensure that the repair is watertight and that the mixture prevents any leaks. This test demonstrates the effectiveness of the gasoline cement styrofoam mixture in repairing a broken bucket, as well as the strength and durability of the patch that has been created. Take a close look at the patched area. There are no signs of water leakage at all. This clearly indicates that the repair is completely sealed and there are no leaks. The result is very satisfying because the mixture, once fully dried, becomes extremely hard and strong. With this level of strength, the patch not only holds water effectively but can also withstand everyday use without easily breaking or cracking. This demonstrates that the gasoline cement styrofoam mixture is indeed highly effective for repairing broken buckets or similar types of damage. In fact, I also tried using this mixture to fill a hole in a wall, and the results were very satisfying. The mixture adheres perfectly and is able to seal the hole without any difficulty. This demonstrates that the gasoline cement styrofoam mixture is not only effective for repairing broken buckets, but can also be used to fix walls that are leaking or cracked. With its sticky and strong texture, this mixture provides a practical and durable solution for various home repairs. Next, when you are outdoors and want to build a campfire or burn wood, sometimes the wood can be difficult to ignite. You don't need to worry, because the first mixture we made, cement and gasoline, can help. This mixture has been left in a sealed container for 24 hours to see whether it would harden or not. The result is that the mixture is still usable and retains its flammable properties, making it perfect for helping to ignite wood. Its sticky and flammable texture is similar to paraffin, making it extremely useful when you are outdoors, such as camping, hunting, or engaging in other outdoor activities. You can store this mixture in a sealed container, which is much safer than carrying pure gasoline. Imagine if you carried gasoline and it spilled inside your backpack, your other equipment could get soaked, which is very dangerous. Unlike pure gasoline, this mixture is safer, more practical to carry anywhere, and still very effective for helping to start a fire. If you found this idea useful, join our community and hit the subscribe button. We'll keep sharing creative ideas that can benefit many people. The gasoline, cement, and styrofoam mixture we showed today is unique, strong, sticky, and flammable. It can be used to repair buckets, fix cracked walls, or even help start a campfire. Leave your questions, feedback, or suggestions in the comments. We'll be happy to answer them. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next creative video.